Hello, I'm Huang Zheng. In the last lesson, we constructed claim, return claim number, and the return is claim. Today, we will complete the return claim number and part of the claim. First, we will define a unit system variable to store the claimed number, named the number of claim. Now let's complete the function claim. Like most programming languages, Solidity have determined statements if else. In our class, the total airdrop time is 1 year, so let's use an if to add the airdrop time. Remember that the time we have defined before. Now we only need to use the current time, that is block.timestamp. Minus time, then we will get how much time has passed from before airdrop beginning to now. Solidity provides time units such as hours, days, months, etc. because there may be 365 or 366 days in a year, so the year unit was cancelled. Now we can use if to judge whether to airdrop time is more than 1 year. If not, then we add 1 to the number of claim. Now let's come to the return claim number function first. This function is to obtain the number of tokens that can be claimed. A local variable claim number can be defined to temporarily store the claimed amount, and the value will be returned at the end of the function. Therefore, in the previous lesson, we used returns. Here, we also add the statement if else. The rule is when the number of claim is less than or equal to 1010, then they can receive 1/1010 of the 20% of all airdrops. More than 1010 but less than 1010 claim can receive 1/100,000 of 80% of all the airdrops. So we use if to judge the number of claim when the number is less than or equal to 1010. Or more than 110 but less than 1010. Set claim number to the amount to be claimed and return claim number. Thank you.